Ladies and gentlemen, that was a light and sound show depicting 400 years of the history of Dhaka as a capital city.
নায়েবে নাজিম শের-ই মসনদ মালিকে মুলুক সম্রাটে জাহান জাহাঙ্গীরের পরাক্রমশীল যোদ্ধা বীর বাহাদুর মুঘল সুবেদার ইসলাম খান হাজি
In 1608, a warship Chandni anchors on the Buriganga River. Subedar Islam Khan, the Mughal governor of Bengal, arrives. Dear audience, gaze upon Islam Khan who you see standing there. Observe the grandeur of the pearls and stones that adorn his royal turban. The clothes he wears and his shoes are embroidered with gold and silver thread. The bright coloured velvet fabric shows off the wealth and influence of the person.
Dear viewers, look opposite to where the Subedar is standing. They are the local inhabitants of Dhaka who have come to receive him. They are wearing dhoti with a nima on top. This dhoti is a 5 meter long homespun cotton cloth that had its origin 3,000 years back as early as the beginning of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa civilization. They are wearing this below the waist and there are no stitches or buttons on this dress. It is wrapped in a stylish way to allow for free movement. The top part of the body is covered with a dress called nima with relatively less stitches.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Mubarak.
That day, the sound of the welcome dhak, the local rhythmic drum, resounded far and wide. It was designated by the Mughals that the physical limits of Dhaka would be as far as the sound would go. Dhaka for ages has been occupied by people belonging to different religions and racial background, and together they have lived in peace. The Bengalis and non-Bengalis, the Hindus, the Muslims, the Buddhists, the Christians have always lived in harmony. But each community had its own dress and style.
After the arrival of the Mughals, their influence was felt by all professions in their lifestyle, culture, industry, etc. Royal robes were decorated with all over floral and paisley design outlined in gold thread and may even have been inlaid with pearl and precious stones, creating a rich, lavish and regal look. Both men and women adorned and decorated their bodies with jewels ranging from turbans and hair accessories, earrings, nose rings, necklaces, armbands, bangles and rings to bell anklets and toe rings. Close to this time, the famous Dhaka muslin started to become internationally known. Inspired by the rich heritage of Mughal fashion, Tutli Rahman has divided her segment into three parts. The first part of the fashion show portrays the Mughal period clothing and accessories worn during their reign. The second part will showcase the different saris styles that were worn during that era. The third part constitutes Tootli's own inspired selections from the rich Mughal era. This is also the new trend which is currently sweeping our subcontinent.
Thank you. Thank you.